Today, we will talk about support reactions and how we can evaluate them. So what are support reactions? Reactions are forces or moments that are generated in the supports to counteract the forces that attempt to move the structure. Thus, equilibrium can be reached and the movement of the structure is prevented. To reach equilibrium, the forces in the horizontal direction should be balanced by reactions in the horizontal direction. So the sum of all forces and reactions in the horizontal direction should be zero. This is the first equilibrium equation, sigma x equals zero. Similarly, the same argument is valid for the forces and the actions in the vertical direction. This gives the second equation, sigma y equals zero. In order to prevent rotation, the moment generated by the forces around any point should be balanced by the moment generated by the reaction around the same point. This gives the third equation, sigma m equals zero. The application of the first two equilibrium equations, sigma x and sigma y, is straightforward. However, the application of the third equation, sigma m, needs some discussion. We can fulfill the equation by taking the moments about any point in the plane of the structure. If we take the moments about point A through point F, we can generate six moment equilibrium equations. In fact, we can generate an unlimited number of equations, but we only have three unknowns, and we only need three equations. Although we can generate an unlimited number of equations, only three of these equations are independent. The rest of the equations are redundant and will not give any new information. That is to say, we can use the first three equations to evaluate the three unknowns. Afterwards, if these values are substituted in the remaining equations, the equations should be automatically satisfied. The additional equations can be used as a check to validate the solution. As said earlier, we need to use three equations to solve for the unknowns. These may be the three main equations, two force equations, sigma x and sigma y, and one moment equation. Or one force equation, sigma x or sigma y, in combination with two moment equations. Or we may use three moment equations and no force equations. We will choose the scenario that simplifies best the solution of the problem. So, how do we apply the equilibrium equations? First, let us talk about sigma x equals zero. In this equation, we only include horizontal forces. The sign of the force is positive if it is pointing to the right. And if we have an inclined force, we have to resolve it into horizontal and vertical components and only include the horizontal component in the equation. We do not include any moments in the equation. For sigma y equals zero, we only include vertical forces and vertical components of inclined forces. The sign of the force is positive if it is pointing upward. And we don't include any moments in the equation. For sigma m equals zero, both the moments and the moments due to the forces are included in the equation. To evaluate the moment caused by the force about a point P, we have to find the arm of the moment, which is the perpendicular distance from point P to the path of the force. The moment caused by the force is equal to the value of the force multiplied by the arm of the force about P. If the force passes through point P, then the arm will be zero and the moment caused by the force about P will be zero, and it will not be included in the equation. The sign of the moment will depend on the direction of rotation of the force around P. If the direction is counterclockwise, then we will consider it positive. If the rotation is in the opposite direction, it will be negative. Moments are included in the equation as is, without being multiplied by any values. The sign convention is similar to the moments caused by the force. Let us look at an example. For the shown beam, we need to evaluate the reactions. The first step in any reactions problem is to specify the reactions. In this problem, we have two supports, a hinged support at A with two reactions, XA and YA, and a roller support at B with one reaction, YB. To evaluate these three reactions, we need to use three equilibrium equations. Let us first apply the first equation, sigma x equals 0. In this equation, we only have one reaction, XA, in the horizontal direction, and no forces. So by applying the equation, XA should be equal to 0. If we use sigma y equals 0 as the next equation, we will find that the equation includes two unknowns, YA and YB. Therefore, to simplify the solution, we will not use sigma y at this stage, and we will choose another equilibrium equation. Let us try the moment about point P. In this case, YB and XA both pass through point P, so their moment about B is 0, and they are not included in the equation. The 5 kN force will have an arm of 5 meters about B, so its moment will be 5 kN multiplied by 5 meters. The direction of rotation around B is counterclockwise, which is positive. Similarly, the 4 kN force will have an arm of 1 meter and will rotate counterclockwise, which is positive. Finally, the reaction YA will produce a moment of minus 10 YA because it has an arm of 10 meter and is rotating clockwise around B. The sum of all the moments should be equal to 0. This equation has only one unknown, YA. By solving the equation, YA is evaluated to be 2.9 kN. After finding YA, now we can use the equation sigma y equals 0, since now we will have only one unknown, which is YB, in this equation. The equation contains four terms, YA and YB, which are pointing upwards, and minus 4 kN and minus 5 kN, which are the forces pointing down. The sum of all forces equals 0. By solving the equation, YB is found to be 6.1 kN. At this stage, all the reactions have been evaluated. The use of any additional equilibrium equation will be redundant and will not provide any additional information. This can be easily proven by using a different equation to evaluate YB. If the value of YB was exactly the same as that evaluated using sigma y, then the additional equation is indeed redundant. Let us take the sum of moments about point A. Both XA and YA pass through point A, so they will not be included in the equation. The equation will include the 5 kN force multiplied by 5 meter arm with a negative sign, clockwise rotation, the 4 kN force multiplied by 9 meter arm with a negative sign, and the reaction YB multiplied by 10 meter arm with a positive sign. All terms should sum to 0. By solving the equation, YB can be evaluated as 6.1 kN, which is exactly the same as that produced using the equation sigma y equals 0. Therefore, the last equation is redundant to the first three equations and not an independent equation. Let us look at a second example. The shown beam has a hinged support at A with two reactions and a roller at B with one reaction. Let us apply first the equation sigma x equals 0. In the horizontal direction, we have two positive forces, XA and a 2 kN force, and one negative force of 4 kN. All forces should sum to 0, giving a value of XA equal to 2 kN. Next, we choose another equilibrium equation that will have only one unknown. Let us try the moment about point B. XA and YB both pass through B and are excluded from the equation. Both the 4 kN and 2 kN force has an arm of 1 meter and rotate around B in a counterclockwise direction, producing positive moments. YA has an arm of 4 meter and is rotating around B in a clockwise negative direction. Solving the equation gives a value of YA of 1.5 kN. Finally, we evaluate YB using the equation sigma y equals 0. By solving the equation, we obtain a value of YB of minus 1.5 kN. The negative sign indicates that the direction of YB, which is assumed upwards, is incorrect. The reaction YB is equal to 1.5 kN pointing downwards. Let us look at the third example. This example is unique in several ways. First, the beam is not subjected to any forces. It is only subjected to a moment of 8 kN acting at point A. Also, the roller at B is inclined, giving an inclined reaction RB. The reaction is perpendicular to the direction of motion of the roller. In order to simplify the calculations, the reaction RB is resolved into its vertical and horizontal components. To solve for the reactions, we start by applying the equilibrium equations and we try to choose an equation that contains only one unknown. Let us try the moment about point B. The two components of RB as well as XA all pass through point B and are not included in our equation. So we are only left with one unknown, which is YA. The equation will contain only two terms, the 8 kN moment, which is included in the equation as is, without being multiplied by any values. Recall that only forces are multiplied by an arm in a moment equation, but moments are not. The sign of this term is negative as it is rotating clockwise. The second term is YA multiplied by the 4 meter arm with a negative sign as it is rotating around B in a clockwise direction. The solution of the equation gives a value of minus 2 for YA, so YA should be reversed as shown. Next, we apply sigma y equals 0. The equation will have only one unknown, RB. By solving the equation, RB is evaluated as 2.83 kN. Finally, we use the third equation, sigma x equals 0. By solving the equation, xA is found to be 2 kN. Now let us look at the final example. The shown frame has a roller at A with one reaction and a hinged support at B with two reactions. In order to work with the distributed load, we need to convert it into an equivalent concentrated force. The equivalent force is equal to 9 kN, which is equal to 3 kN per meter multiplied by the length of the load, which is the 3 meter. The equivalent force is acting at the middle of the distributed load. First, we take the sum of moments about point B. XB and YB both pass through B and are not included in the equation. So YA is the only unknown in this equation. The terms of the equations are minus YA multiplied by 6 meter arm because it is rotating clockwise around B. The horizontal 6 kN force multiplied by 4 meter arm with a negative sign. the equivalent 9 kN force multiplied by 4.5 meter arm with a positive sign, because it is rotating counterclockwise. By solving the equation, YA is found to be 2.75 kN. Next, we use sigma y equals 0, giving YB as 6.25 kN. Finally, we use sigma x equals 0 to obtain XB, which is equal to 6 kN. Thank you for watching.